Hi guys, Nightshift10000 here with a new video. And this is kind of an impromptu quickie video that I decided to do on the fly. And it really is on the fly. I am doing this parked in my car after having done a strenuous day of yard work and housework. I'm doing this to relax, bringing you a new video. So yeah, as you can all see, we are on the Tiermaker website and we are in their political ideologies with labels. Thank you, Paige. Yeah, I saw a fellow YouTube political commentator do something like this, and I decided to do my own. So yeah, that's what we're doing here tonight. So yeah, we're going to go through and you're going to get a more in-depth look at my political views and what political views I think are the best, as opposed to which ones I think are shit. Now, I'm well aware that my audience more than likely has a pretty good idea of where I lean politically, but I'm still going to do this because I do want to get a more in-depth look at my political leanings and, you know, what I think is great as opposed to what I think is not great and what I think belongs into, you know, what I think should go into the trash can of cringe. So yeah, we're going to be doing this. And again, I want to thank whoever made this with labels. You are awesome. I have done political tiers like this before where there were no labels and I didn't know what half of them were. And I saw the labels and I was like, oh shit, okay, that's what that is. That's which one that is. Okay, great. So yeah, whoever made this with labels, you are awesome. Thank you so much. And I also wanted to bring this up. I've done past political tiers like this, political ideology tiers like this, where they'd had no labels again, and I got a few of them mixed up. So if you see any of those, and I accidentally put ones like anarcho-nihilism and like S tier and anarcho or agorism in C tier, it's because I got them mixed up. I didn't know which one was which. So this is my canon tier. This is the one that is true. All of the ones that I've done in the past, they don't mean anything anymore. This is the canon one. This is the canon political ideologies tier. So yeah, let's get into this. All right, accelerationism. Okay, this one definitely goes in A tier. Now, I've talked about accelerationism before. It's the act of getting rid of the government, getting rid of the state as quick as possible, accelerating the state's collapse and getting rid of it. I've talked about this in at least one of my videos before, and I talked about my wants and reservations with it. And usually it would be in C tier. However, I spoke to a few fellow agorists and they assured me that my worries were probably not well-founded and that society would go the correct path if, you know, accelerationism was ever, for lack of a better word, accelerated. So yes, it's going in A tier. I do still have some reservations with it, but they're not that strong. And so it's definitely an A tier one now. Okay, agorism. So we have agorism. As you all know, I think agorism is fucking awesome. It is an epic ideology, and I love agorism. I absolutely love it. I've done multiple videos where I've explained my views on agorism and where I've explained agorism itself. If you want to learn more about it, please go look those up. I've really got to get through this as fast as possible, but yeah, go look those up. Or actually look up videos that are directly that directly go into agorism, or look, even better, please look up agorist literature, like the new Libertarian Manifesto by Samuel Konkin III. That one goes into a lot of depth on what agorism is. It goes into a lot of detail, and it's definitely a good resource. So yeah, but agorism, in my opinion, is absolutely awesome. I love it. So yeah. Okay, agrarianism. That one goes in C tier. Agrarianism is okay. I mean, I get it. People want to get back to the roots. They want to farm more old-fashioned. They want to get back to the earth, or, you know, get to know the earth better, and they think that agrarianism can do that. Maybe you have, like, Amish views on farming and living, and that's fine. My reservations on it, or my reservations with it, are mainly how easily slavery and aspects of slavery can be integrated with agrarianism, and also how agrarianism does not evolve or advance and how it is kind of backwards looking and is non-innovative at all. So yeah, those are the drawbacks, and they're pretty major because I do believe in heavy innovation. I do not believe in slavery. I think slavery is fucked up. But yeah, I mean, if you want to be agrarian, simply to, you know, get back to your roots, get back to the earth, or because it's in your core political beliefs, as long as you're not violating anyone's rights, it's fine, but it's definitely C tier for me. Okay, here we go. Here is the lucky winner, number one. American conservatism. It goes right there in the trash can of cringe. Yeah, you know, you're Trump, you're America, and you're go dirkader. Don't mean for much here on my page or with me. So please, if you are an American conservative, please click the hell off this video and click and unsubscribe if you're subscribed to me. But yeah, it is definitely trash can of cringe material, and it goes bye-bye. Anarchism. Okie dokie. Here we go. Here's another great one. Anarchism. I definitely identify as an anarchist. You can make up whatever snarky ass comments you want to about me, but I am an anarchist. I identify with anarchism. I love anarchism. I love the idea of, you know, the individuality that it provides. It's kinship to voluntary interactions between individuals. And it, you know, anarchisms want to start a society that is without force or compulsion. So yeah, I mean, and here's the thing, for anyone who does not fully understand what anarchism is, don't be fooled by the Antifa morons. Don't be fooled by the losers that call themselves anarchists, because but they go out and they destroy shit. They go out and hurt people. They are not anarchists. They are not anarchists in the slightest. Anarchism, to put it simply, is this. Anarchists believe in do no harm, but take no shit. That is the anarchist credo. That is the most basic way I can put it. And yeah, that's just what anarchism is all about in the end. So yeah. Anarcho-capitalism, that goes in the trash can of cringe. No. I'm just fucking around. No. That goes in S tier. I identify as an anarcho-capitalist. I'm more akin to voluntarist, because they're pretty much the same thing. Voluntarism and anarcho-capitalism are the same. They're pretty much the same. I understand what some people have reservations by calling themselves anarcho-capitalists or identifying with anarcho-capitalism. The way I see it is this. I would almost more like to call myself an anarcho-free marketist or a free market anarchist, because that's the way I see capitalism. Is the only true form of capitalism is free market capitalism, without any of the perversions of capitalism that have come, like corporatism, crony capitalism, or state capitalism. Those are perversions of the capitalist economic ideology and have no place within anarcho-capitalism or within capitalism, period. So for me, anarcho-capitalism is complete voluntary free market capitalism. That is what it is. And I have no problem identifying with that, because capitalism to me is just that. It is complete free market capitalism. So yeah, I have no problem with that. And for anyone who does, don't worry. If your idea is free market capitalism, then that's what capitalism is all about. So no worries. No worries on that one. Anarcho-communism, on the other hand, that one goes right here in the trash can of cringe. No, I've explained many times why I do not believe anarcho-communists are anarchists. And it's mainly because anarcho-communism espouses direct democracy and collective rule, and collective ownership, actually, which are all akin to governments and states. Because, you know, who enforces those things? So, yes. And here's the other thing. It's also very hierarchical, because it creates because again, going back to the direct democracy part, it creates the hierarchy of the majority over the minority. So, yeah, anarcho-communism is not only hierarchical, it is completely not anarchist in any way, shape, or form. Hate to break it to y'all, but that's the way it is. What the fuck? Okay, and following anarcho-communism, we have anarcho-fascism. What in the hell? How do you do that? How do you take something that is completely antithetical to anarchism and make an anarchist? I don't understand. I don't get it. Okay, anarcho-feminism, not quite cringeworthy, at least not to me. I know it is to some people, but not to me. But it's definitely not great. It has some major drawbacks, and so, but I'm not going to put it in the trash can of cringe. It's definitely D tier, but yeah, it's not anything great, but it's not absolutely the worst. So, and I know I'm going to piss off some of my followers with this, but anarcho-monarchism. Yeah, you go in the trash can of cringe. I do not identify with that at all. I don't see how that actually can be an anarcho. So, yeah. And another one, what in the hell? How do you do that? Okay, yeah, no. I'll take things that don't exist for 2000, Alex. No, okay, anarcho-nihilism, okie dokie, that one goes right here. That one is more like a more extreme version of centrism. That one's just kind of like, you know, nothing matters, no one matters, let's just all kill ourselves. It's more or less kind of like this. I feel so lonely, nobody gets me, I am so unhappy, why can't I find a cool alternative boyfriend? Yeah, it's very much like that. So, it's nothing great, but it's also nothing terrible. So I'll just leave it in C tier. Okay, anarcho-pacifism. I want to say this. I have a lot of respect for anarcho-pacifists. I do not identify as one because I am a believer in the NAP. However, I do respect people that do have anarcho-pacifist beliefs, and they are definitely welcome in Ancapistan. The main part of anarcho-pacifism is do no wrong, which is a big hoorah, but there's also no form of self-defense, and they don't believe in defending themselves, so that's a big haru. So, but yeah, anarcho-pacifism, you know, if you want to lead that kind of life, go ahead. But at one point, I think you kind of have to ask, you know, am I following my principles or am I just being a damage sponge? I mean, at what point do I fight back? At what point do I stand up for myself? Or am I just, you know, a doormat? Am I just basically a doormat? So, yeah, anarcho-pacifists, I respect you, but these are questions you might have to ask yourselves. Moving on. Anarcho-primitivism. Okay, again, not quite a cringe ideology, but not a great one. It's, you know, it's pretty much get rid of science, get rid of technology, get rid of education, logic, reason. Well, not so much logic, but maybe like, you know, the knowledge that we have now, and go back to the Stone Age when we lived in caves and mud huts and where we were hunter-gatherers, where there was no real technology outside of fire and spears and whatnot, and where we died of constant animal predation and easily curable diseases. And okay, so to sum it up, it's kind of like this. Take it away, Bender.
Oh, mirrors reflecting mirrors. High-tech sorcery. Sorcery, I say!
Yeah, that's one of the easiest illustrations I can show for anarcho-primitivism. So, yeah, not quite cringe, but it's not great. Anarcho-syndicalism, on the other hand. Okay, again, not anarchism. Anarcho-syndicalism, if you research it and, you know, if you go in depth with this one, it's pretty much what we have now. It is a representative Republican government rebranded and relabeled with the word anarcho in front of it for some reason. Yeah, you have the syndicate, you have your elected syndicate leaders, and you have the syndicate head, which we would call Comrade Trump. But yeah, anarcho-syndicalism, it's pretty much a representative Republican government rebranded and relabeled with the word anarcho in front of it. It has nothing to do with anarchism. It's also hierarchical and uses money because the syndicate leaders form the hierarchy. Yeah, let that sink in. Anarcho-transhumanism, okie dokie. Right up here in S tier. And yes, I am an anarcho-transhumanist. Do you hear that, Nate the Voluntarist? Pluto is not the only anarcho-transhumanist you know. I am an anarcho-transhumanist. I believe in it. I love it. It's great. In my opinion, though, anarcho-transhumanism, I would call it the anarcho-capitalism of the future, mainly because I believe that if and when anarcho-capitalism and agorism do succeed and are integrated into society, that anarcho-transhumanism will quickly be integrated with it, and that it will make people's lives easier to augment themselves in certain ways. And yeah, it'll pretty much be like Shadowrun or Cyberpunk, basically, where augmentations become normal and easily purchasable. So yes, I would definitely say it's the anarcho-capitalism of the future. And it's not just about mechanical or nanotechnological augmentations, it's also about biological and genetic augmentations, gene editing, and it's whatever you want it to be. It's whatever you have the money to purchase, and it's whatever you want it to be. And more than likely, in an anarcho-capitalist society, augmentations would be easily affordable, mainly due to things that I've talked about in past videos. But yeah, I do believe that anarcho-transhumanism is a positive for society. I absolutely love it, and I again call it the anarcho-capitalism of the future. So yeah, anarcho-transhumanism for the win. Okay, anti-radicalism. It's a C tier. Again, for lack of a better word, it's a radical form of centrism. It's not being convicted towards anything, which is fine if you want to live like that, if you want to live without conviction. They come down on me for being so convicted to anarcho-capitalism and so convicted to what, you know, to what I believe in. And if you're convicted to something, they'd come down on you for the same reason. So yeah, it's more centrist, and there's nothing really to tell about it. Apoliticalism is the same. It's more or less the same. You don't really identify with any kind of political party or political class. You're just kind of there. So it's kind of the same thing. It's definitely in the middle. Okay, here we go. Authoritarian capitalism. You know, I would put it in the trash can of cringe. I'll give it a little wiggle room because of the faint pieces of capitalism that it has. There's some faint capitalism there, but it is very much like crony capitalism, very much like state capitalism, and is a complete perversion of what capitalism should be. So it goes in D tier. Again, I will give it some mercy points, but yeah, it is D. Yes, it is D tier. Passing car. Ba'athism. Okay. Ba'athism, unless I am incorrect, and please tell me if I am in the comments below. Ba'athism is an Iraqi offshoot of fascism. The Ba'ath Party was the party of Saddam Hussein. Now, okay, going off on a tangent, I know I shouldn't be doing this, but going off on a tangent, back in the dark days that I do not like to speak of, I was myself an American conservative. Back in my American conservative days, I voted for Bush once, mainly because I wasn't old enough to vote for him the first time, but I did vote for him once, and I was for the war in Iraq back then. I am not now. Frankly, I think it's one of the biggest mistakes America has ever made. But yeah, the biggest reason I was for it back then, and the only reason I would ever say that the war in Iraq was a positive now, was to get rid of the cruel and brutal dictator Saddam Hussein. Saddam Hussein, he was terrible. He was god-awful. He did unspeakable acts to people, his own people, and to people who came in from abroad. And I don't know if he founded the Ba'ath Party, but the Ba'ath Party was what kept him in control. Ba'athism was his ideology. It was what he used to control the people. And it is. It's pretty much a form of fascism, so it goes in the trash can of cringe. Goodbye on that one. Cajalism. Okay, so Cajalism is, it's kind of like an offshoot of Gaulism, which is like a French form of fascism. So, yeah, from what I'm aware of, it is also a form of fascism, so it goes in the trash can of cringe. Capitalism. Okay, just basic capitalism goes in A tier. I've got no problem with basic capitalism as long as it stays free market capitalism and does not succumb to the corruptions of capitalism. But yeah, it's A tier mainly because it's kind of a blank slate of capitalism. But yeah, if it's not anarcho-capitalism or if it's not free market capitalism, it's fine. You know, I mean, if it's not directly that, it's still fine. I mean, it can still be that, but it still looks like it can succumb to those corruptions. So, yeah, I'll put it in A tier, but yeah, because, like, you know, basic free market capitalism is great. But yeah, if it can succumb to those things, no thank you. Capitalist com. The Capcoms. Yeah, I don't see how you can make that work. So yeah, trash can of cringe. It goes in the dark zone. Centrism. Okay. Centrism, again, goes in C tier. It's nothing big. It's just you're kind of in the middle. It's kind of in the center. So yeah, whatever. Christian democracy. Okay. Christian democracy. Yeah, it goes in the D tier. It's nothing horrible. It's nothing, you know, it's not quite cringe, but it's nothing. It's not great. Christian theocracy, on the other hand. Well, that goes right here. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever wanted to go back to those wonderful, horrible days in medieval Europe and in the medieval West when people could be burned at the stake for disagreeing with the church on something, where you could be decapitated or crucified for leaving the church or saying that the Christian God did not exist or that there were multiple gods, and where your religion was completely mowed down in the name of Jesus and the church? Me neither. Me neither. So no, Christian theocracy, not my thing, and it goes in the trash can of cringe. It goes in the dark zone. Same with civic nationalism. I don't know why you would ever be a civic nationalist. I don't know. God, I don't know who would do that, but no, thank you. That one goes in the dark zone. Thank you very much. Classical liberalism. Okay. Surprisingly enough, classical liberalism is going in A tier. I know my fair share of classical believers in direct classical liberalism. It is the kind of ancestry of conservatism. I'm actually more of a fan of neoclassical liberalism because that's more or less the ancestry of libertarianism. But classical liberalism is okay. It's a good ideology overall. It still does espouse some authority, which I'm not for, but it's okay. And if you're a classical liberalism, you know, or if you're a believer in classical liberalism, we're cool. We can be friends. We can be friends. We're cool. Yeah. Clerical fascism, on the other hand, you go in the dark zone. Communalism, you go in the dark zone as well. Communist monarchism. What in the high holy shit is that? Dark zone. Conservatism. Okay. No, hold on. Conservatism, that is D tier. It's not as terrible as any kind of nationalist conservatism, but yeah, it's a pretty bad ideology overall, but you know, whatever. It is what it is. Conservative liberalism. Okay. Yeah, you go in the dark zone. Conservative socialism also goes in the dark zone. Okay. Constitutional monarchism, not quite dark zone material. However, like any constitutional form of government, it, you know, the Constitution, it is a security blanket. It doesn't really do anything. It is not self-enforcing. And constitutional governments, it doesn't matter how you found them, it doesn't matter what they are, they will fail. They are no more than one ruler or one government away from being violated. Or hell, they can be violated by the same ruler, by the same government that signed them, if no one's paying attention. And constitutional monarchism is pretty much the most common to fall to that, because, I mean, if you're a student of history, or is even if you've watched my videos, I've talked about this, the king that signed the Magna Carta, well, after him, there was Henry VIII, who had no problem using the Magna Carta as a mouth wipe and an ass wipe. So yeah, it just doesn't work. Constitutional governments, they don't work. It's just a security blanket for the people, and it doesn't really bring about any kind of positive change. So yeah. Corporate Buddhism. Nope, it goes in the trash can of cringe. Yeah, no thanks. Council socialism, also trash can of cringe. Democratic monarchism. Okay, so no, it goes in D tier. The only form of of democratic monarchism I can think of is referencing episode one from Star Wars. And no, not episode four. I'm talking about episode one, the very first one, The Phantom Menace, where they, where the planet of Naboo would elect their queen or elect their king for a set term of years. That's exactly what happens, is that a kingdom will elect their monarchs, and they will elect their monarchs for a set amount of time or for a life term, which is a really bad idea. But yeah, it's, yeah, that's kind of why it's not a great form of government. Democratic socialism. The trash can of cringe you go. Dark zone. No, thank you. Distributionism. Also dark zone. Eco-anarchism. Oh, okay. No. Hold on. Eco-anarchism goes in there. I'm a fan of eco-anarchism. I'm okay with it, as long as it doesn't get violent, as long as it doesn't get rowdy. I'm fine with eco-anarchism. I think it's a B-level. I think it's a B-tier ideology, frankly. So, yeah, eco-anarchism, it's fine. It's okay. Eco-fascism, on the other hand, trash can of cringe. Eco-socialism, same. Egoism, okay. Egoism, hold on. No. Don't flip out. Egoism, I would definitely put it here in C tier. Egoism, it's, from what I understand of it, it's kind of like an anarchist centrism where everything is a spook. Nothing really matters. I can't really get behind it, but it's nothing terrible. So egoism is definitely C tier. Environmentalism. Okay. Hold on. No. Hold on. Environmentalism is B. I'm for it. I'm for protecting the environment. I've talked about free market environmentalism, which I'm pretty sure eco-anarchism might be. I don't know. Eco-anarchism might actually have elements of that. But, as long as it doesn't come to any kind of violence, I'm okay with environmentalism. I definitely believe in preserving the environment as much as possible and even making it marketable to do that. So, yeah, environmentalism is okay. Esoteric fascism. Okay. Back alley philosophy. Esoteric the free. If you're watching this, bud. if you ever wanted to troll the commies, or if you ever wanted to troll people on Twitter, esoteric fascist might be a good one to go with. So, just putting that out there, buddy, if you're watching. Esoteric fascism, however, goes in the trash can of cringe. Along with fascism. Fascism. God, I wish there was a lower tier than that I could put fascism in. Yeah, fuck fascism. Fuck it with a cactus with broken obsidian and placed in it. Yeah. Feminism. Okay, like anarcho-feminism, it goes in D tier. I'm not a fan of feminism or what it has become. It's not totally cringe. It is cancer, to quote Milo Yiannopoulos, but not quite cringe, not quite horribly as cringy. It did have some good ideas to begin with, but what it's become is just bad. Feudalism, okay. I've been told this for so long, and I'm just going to say this now. Anarcho-capitalism is not feudalism, and I will even put it up now why it is not. I will explain it, and I will put up now why it is not, right here. Now, I can explain the differences between anarcho-capitalism and feudalism in my own words, but I feel that there are people out there that have given maybe some better answers than I could. So, yeah, I'm going to be reading an answer given by a man named Rob Weyer, which is really excellent in my opinion. It explains the differences between anarcho-capitalism and feudalism, just really extensively. And I feel like, it would be better, told from that and maybe give it up to someone else. So yeah, what are the similarities between anarcho-capitalism and feudalism? None. Where the false comparison comes up is it is typical from those who are unfamiliar with both feudalism and anarcho-capitalism and who argue from vague sentiments about power. Hold on. Nope. No. Don't want to do that. Feudalism was based on an imposed, meaning involuntarily forced and restricted form of land tenure called entitle, also called fee tail, as compared to fee simple we see today, where a large landowner could not break up his estate, could not sell it, could not even borrow against it to raise money to make improvements. He could only pass it along to a single heir who was determined not by his wishes, but by the rule of, and I know I'm going to butcher this word, primogeniture, I guess, i.e. to the first son. This restriction in ownership rights enforced concentrated ownership against the wishes of the property owner, who would often have been personally better off, I think that's what he meant, better off, if he could have sold a portion of land for greater revenue than he could get from rent. In an anarcho-capitalist system, and in fact, as it is even today, a property owner is generally free to buy and sell land to whomever he chooses, or whomever they wish. Whenever they wish, and to subdivide the land as they wished. Limited by local land use restrictions on things like minimum lot size. The result is that land ownership concentration is vastly reduced. Hayek got it right. The power which a multiple millionaire, who may be my neighbor and perhaps my employer, has over me is very much less than that which the smallest functionaire possesses who wields the coercive power of the state, and on whose discretion it depends whether and how I am to be allowed to live or to work. Yeah, anarcho-capitalism, not feudalism. And if you want to know what I think of feudalism, it goes right down here in the trash can of cringe. Fuck feudalism. Geolibertarianism, okay. Geolibertarianism goes right here in A tier. It's okay. I actually am kind of a fan. I'm okay with it. It's overall a cool ideology. Not great, but it's still pretty good. Georgism, on the other hand, you go down here. No fucking thank you. Green conservatism. I'd say that's D tier, honestly. Green liberalism, on the other hand, you go in the trash can of cringe. You go in the dark zone. No thank you. Okay, green libertarianism. I'm thinking that is free market libertarianism or free market environmentalism. I would definitely put that in A tier. That is definitely okay with me. I know that being an anarcho-capitalist, I'm not totally supposed to be for it, but I actually think it's got a lot of good ideas. Free market environmentalism, look it up. I've talked about it in the past, but please feel free to look it up, because there's some good ideas there, in my opinion. Hive mind collectivism, you go down here in the dark zone. Hoppianism. Okay, no, don't freak out. Hoppianism goes right here. In fact, I'll even put it ahead of accelerationism. I think I'm enough of a Hoppian to identify as a Hoppian. I agree with it enough. There's kind of more on its basic underpinnings. I'm definitely enough of a Hoppian that I can identify with Hoppianism. And yeah, a lot of its ideas are okay. A lot of its ideas are actually really great. Hans Hermann Hoppe has got a lot of great ideas, especially on secession, which agorists also believe in as well. I just think that agorist secession is a little bit more effective. But in any case, Hoppianism is great. I do love the idea of secessionism. My only reservations are the physical removals. And correct me if I'm wrong, but Hans Hermann Hoppe actually does agree more or less with Pinochet that communists need to be dropped out of helicopters. I'm going to set the record straight. That is, among anarcho-capitalists like myself, that is predominantly a joke. And yeah, it's a dark humor. It's an off-color joke. I understand that, but it is a joke nonetheless. I'm pretty sure that Hoppians overall are actually for that to some degree. I am not. So yeah, I agree with a lot of what Hoppe actually says, but I'm not the biggest believer in it. So yeah, it's more A tier than S tier. Almost S tier though. Huxleyism. Okay, you go in the trash can of cringe. Identitarianism, also the trash can of cringe. Ingsoc. Oh. Do you see the prisoners hanged? No, but I shall see it on the screens. No. I'm sorry, but Big Brother, BB, you go down here in the trash can of cringe. No, thank you. No. Oceania, you are not okay. Integralism. Integralism, I'm not going to put that in the trash can of cringe. It goes D tier. It's D tier for me. Islamism, however, that is in the trash can of cringe. And what in the hell is that? What in the hell? Jewish Nazism, is that even real? Okay, in the comments, I want people to tell me, is Jewish Nazism actually something that exists? I mean, really? Seriously? Oh, God. How self-destructive do you have to be to believe in such a thing? Okay. Juche, you are in the trash can of cringe. Kayanism. Okay. Not quite trash can of cringe, but I would definitely put it in the D tier. It's not cringe, but it's not great. And liberal conservatism. Nope, trash can of cringe. It goes in the dark zone. Liberalism goes in the dark zone as well. Ugh. And it's really more of what liberalism has become. You know, it started out okay, but it's become super, super cringe. So no, thank you. Okay, libertarian market socialism. I don't know if this is the same thing as mutualism. However, this is going to surprise a lot of people. It's not fucking terrible. I would definitely put it in C tier. It's not great, but it's not terrible. It's kind of in between. It's kind of in the middle. So, yeah, it's going in there. Libertarian socialism, on the other hand, it goes in the dark zone. Libertarianism, okay. Hold the fuck on. Libertarianism is definitely A tier. Libertarians, you know, they're kind of statist, but they're okay. They're okay people. It's an okay ideology. Longism goes in the trash can of cringe. Luxembourgism goes in the trash can of cringe. Maoism, you go bye-bye. Go to the dark zone. Market socialism. Again, not terrible, but not great. So yeah, into the C tier. Marxist-Leninism, you go bye-bye. Get wrecked, fool. Get yeeted. Mercantilism. Okay. Mercantilism. That goes in D tier. It's not quite cringe, however. Mercantilism, it's very much like state capitalism. It's only on an older aesthetic. It was largely the economic system amongst royalty and amongst kingdoms. It's where a kingdom would take in raw materials. And it would churn out merchandise and whatnot. And it was government-controlled economics taken to pretty much its logical conclusion. So, yeah, it's not great. Minarchism, on the other hand. Okay, minarchism. Minarchism goes right here. It's okay. It's not great. I don't know how libertarianism and minarchism differ from each other. But, It's okay. It's an okay ideology. It's actually pretty good. Well, yeah, we'll get the minarchists. We'll get the minarchists soon. Monarchism. Okay, go in the trash can of cringe. I don't know who could ever want that. Yeah. Solo dictator called the king. Okay, mutualism. Okay. All right. Again. Not great, but not terrible either. So definitely goes in the middle. National anarchism. Yeah. Anarcho-fascism again. Goes right there. National Bolshevism. Bullshitism. Got it. National conservatism. Ew. Dark Zone, all of you. Well, not all of these, but you get the gist. Nationalism goes in the Dark Zone. Nazism. And again, I wish there was a tier lower than F to put it in. Fuck Nazism. Fuck the Nazis. Fuck that whole thing. No. No, 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 no. May if there is a hell in this universe, may the Nazis burn in the lowest level of it. If you are a Nazi and you're subscribed to me, unsubscribe now, you fucker. Get off my channel. Yeah, you know, I've heard it said before, and I'll just say it now. Hitler committed suicide by shoving two cyanide capsules up his ass and then putting a gun to his head and pulling the trigger. If you are a Nazi, if you believe that the Nazi ideology is right, follow your fucking leader. And I say that completely unashamedly. Fuck Nazism. Fuck it hard. Neoconservatism, also in the Dark Zone. Neoliberalism. Okay, I've explained why anarcho-capitalism is not neoliberalism. I'm not going to explain that again here, but yeah. In case you're planning on spouting off that neoliberalism is anarcho-capitalism, don't even bother. I've explained why it is not before, and it is not. Fuck neoliberalism too. Neo-reactionaryism, goodbye. One nation conservatism. Not quite trash can of cringe. It goes in D tier. No, thank you. Paleo-libertarianism, okay. Paleo-libertarianism, and I've got to jog up, don't I? Wow. Putting a lot in the trash, aren't I? Paleo-libertarianism is okay. It is an okay ideology. I definitely, you know, look it up. It might even be, you know, it might even be for you. It might even be an ideology that you like, but it's okay. It's not anything great. It's no great shakes, but it's okay. Paleo-conservatism, okay. Paleo-conservatism. This is going to surprise a lot of people. Where I'm going to put this. No, no, no. Hey, come on. Okay, technical difficulties aside, I'm putting in B tier. Ugh. Fucking cars. Anyway, paleo-conservatism. It's okay. It's, you know, I mean, it's less okay than paleo-libertarianism or the A tiers, but it's B tier. It's all right. Peronism. Okay. Peronism. Yeah, that's like an Argentinian offshoot of fascism. And if Peron or Peronism sounds familiar, his wife was Evita Peron. They did the movie about her, the musical with Madonna of back in the 90s, back in the late 90s. It had that, you know, it had that song.
Don't cry for me, Argentina.
Stop that. You're not going into a song while I'm here.
Yeah, that one where, our parents would listen to it and they'd love it, but us kids, we just wanted to gouge our eardrums out after listening to it. But yeah, she was the wife of the dictator that came, of the Argentinian dictator that came up with Peronism. It is an Argentinian form of fascism, so it goes in F tier, it goes in the Dark Zone. And here we go, Pinochetism. This one is Chilean fascism, and yes, it goes in the trash can of cringe too. As I said before, the whole dropping commies out of helicopters, that is an off-color anarcho-capitalist joke, and it is a response to the very serious threat that communists and anarcho and quote-unquote anarcho-communists make, that they are going to execute anarcho-capitalists and capitalists like myself. Those threats are very serious and not at all like the jokes that we make on that. But yes, Pinochet, he was a fascist dictator, and fascism can get fucking yeeted. Pirate politics. Okay, pirate politics. This is going to surprise all of ye. Plunder the booties, lads. Yer, surrender that booty. Yes, pirate politics. It belongs in A tier because pirate politics is okay. Yeah. It's an okay ideology. I don't know. It's actually pretty anarchist, if you want the truth about it. It can be anarchistic. It can be pretty anarchistic. So, yeah, it's an okay one. It's not any great shakes, but it's okay. Grr. Platformism. Goodbye. Get yeeted, fuckers. Pol Potism. Post-sadism. Oh, God. Yes, if Scientologists had a communist Marxist ideology, that'd be it. It is intergalactic alien Marxism mixed with an affinity or a desire for nuclear conflict. I don't know how you convince people that nuclear conflict is for the greater good, but yeah, no, post-sadism goes right down here in the trash can of cringe. Yeah, no. Yeah, sorry, Lord Xenu, but your ideology does not work here. Your ideology does not fly here. Progressive conservatism. Okay. Progressive conservatism. Goes here in D tier. It's not quite cringe, but it's not great. Progressivism. You know what? I will be nice, and I will put progressivism in D tier. It can be good. It's only when it gets twisted, usually by progressives, that it can become pretty cringy. But I'll give it mercy points and put it in D tier, because it's not always horrible. Queer anarchism. Sorry, but queer anarchism is not fabulous. No, it goes in the D tier. It goes right down here. Yeah, not great. Not great. Not absolutely cringy, but it's not great. Oh, sweetheart. That is just so heartbreaking. Okay, I'm done. Anyway. Radical centrism. I don't know. Again, I'll take things that don't exist for 2000, Alex. This doesn't seem like that would exist. I mean, how can you be a radical centrist. I don't get how that works, but I'll put it in C tier because it is centralism. C for centrism. Social Darwinism. Okay. Again, not anarcho-capitalism. It has nothing to do with social Darwinism. However, I'm not going to put social Darwinism. I'm going to put it in D tier. I'm not the biggest fan of social Darwinism, but honestly, sometimes I look at their beliefs, sometimes I look at ideologies and I think, would it be better if we cleared the gene pool or we cleared the political gene pool of some of these things or allowed it to be cleared of some of these things naturally? I just don't know. I'm not for it, but I mean, sometimes it makes me wonder. Social democracy. Oh, God. Goes right down here in the trash can of cringe. Social liberalism, the same. Good God. Social libertarianism. I know what that is. And I'll give it mercy points. I'll put it in B tier because it can be kind of cringy. But the libertarian part of it, the libertarianism part of it kind of balances things out, but it can be kind of cringy. So I'll B-tier it. Social nationalism. Get yeeted. Socialism goes to the dark zone. Stalinism goes straight to the dark zone. Strasserism. Get fucked. Technocratism. Okay. You know what? For its affinity for science and scientific advancement and knowledge, I will list it in D tier. I am not a fan of technocratism. I am not a big fan of it, but for its adherence to science and for its wanting to advance science and knowledge, I'll give it D tier. I'll give it D tier status. Titoism. Good fucking bye. Okay. Basic transhumanism. Okay. I'll put it in B tier. I'll B tier it because it's okay as long as it stays voluntarist, as long as, you know, if it's anarcho-transhumanism, I'm good with it. But yeah, when it becomes mandatory or when the government takes it over, it can be pretty bad. But for the idea of transhumanism, I'll give it B tier. Trotskyism, you go down here. Ultranationalism, dark zone. Zeism, dark zone. Zionism. I want a dark zone it so bad. However, it doesn't necessarily have to be cringe. It's definitely D tier, but it's not necessarily cringe. What? And oh my God, what is this? How? Oh wow. Okay. Is this like the after effect of the nuclear war and the aliens coming down to say that you were all fucking idiots for nuking yourselves into oblivion? Get yeeted. Anarcho-Poseidonism. How do you do that? How? No, it goes in the dark zone of cringe. Goodbye. Pan-Africanism. Okay. Hold on. Calm down. Calm the fuck down, everyone. Actually, no. Pan-Africanism, it's okay. It's not any great shakes, but it's okay. Yeah, I would definitely put it in the middle. I mean, you know, if you want to go that way, that's great. That's fine by me. Yeah, Pan-Africanism is okay. And the same goes for Pan-Arabism. It's fine. I mean, if you want to go that way, if you believe that a society like that can be formed, go for it. Definitely. I would definitely put those both in C tier. Pan-Africanism and Pan-Arabism, definitely go C tier. They're not any great shakes, but again, they're not terrible. Autonomism. Okay. That one is kind of deceptive. That one kind of has a deceptive title to it. So, trash can of cringe you go. Conservative libertarianism. That one can be kind of deceptive as well. However, I will give it B tier status. I will give it B tier status because, you know, it is somewhat libertarian. I definitely wouldn't go with it myself, but yeah, if you want to, that's fine. Delianism, okay, right there. No, you go trash can of cringe. Guild socialism goes the same way. Jihadism also goes trash can of cringe. Masculinism. I'm gonna get shit canned, but yeah. C tier. Yeah. Oh shit. I know. Just, you know, save the snarky comments. I don't give a shit. Circulus. Okay. No. Trash can of cringe. Kemalism. Oh, fuck off. Thalangism. Also fuck off. Oh, wow, I'm really trash canning of cringe a lot of these, aren't I? Nasserism, go bye-bye. Mobutism, get fucked. Kameme, oh no, fuck the fuck off, motherfucker. Animal welfareism, okay. I am no animal rights activist by any means. I like my meat, but when it comes to the overt cruelty to animals, I am against that completely. I don't believe that meat eating is cruelty to animals. We've hunted ever since the beginning of time, even before we were technically Homo sapiens sapiens. We hunted. We've always been primarily carnivorous. I'm not saying that that's the best diet, and I'm definitely mix some other things in with that. But we've been primarily carnivorous, so I don't see our predation of other animals as overt cruelty. But it's more. There are cruelties. There are cruelties to animals, and I am not for it. So I would definitely put animal welfareism in A tier. I would definitely put it high up there. Yeah, animals deserve at least some respect. Bonapartism. Good fucking bye. Christian anarchist. I don't know why they put it in black and red. The Christian anarchism I am familiar with is like, it's white and black. Kind of like anarcho-pacifism. But in Christian anarchism, because here's the thing, it's not, Christian anarchism is not overtly ancommunist or anarcho-communist or, yeah, quote-unquote anarcho-communist. So I will put it in B tier because Christian anarchism is okay. Leo Tolstoy, definitely look him up, please. He'll set you straight. And he's even as an atheist, he's definitely someone that, you know, that I see as kind of a model of anarchism. So, yeah. Classical Marxism. Garbage can of cringe. Confederatism. Get fucked. Corporatism. As I said before, get fucked. Erdogan. Okay, yeah. No, goodbye. Gaullism, as I mentioned before. French fascism, go away. Fuck off. Fuck the fuck off. No, it's not quite cringe, but it's not a great ideology either, so I'm going to put it up here. I'm going to put it up here, right here, in D tier. I'm going to get through this. Hindutvada, okay. Again, not quite cringe, but not great. Ho Chi Minh thought. Go fuck yourself. Illegalism. Okay, here we go. Here's one I can put up there. If I can jog my way through it. Wow, I've really trash canned a lot of these. Illegalism goes in A tier. It doesn't matter to me. Break them all. Break them all. You know what? Laws fucking suck. Jacksonism. Nope. Go fuck yourself. Kirchnerism. Nope. Goodbye. Metaxism. Fuck off. Ordo liberalism. Goodbye. What is that? Oh, okay. Penchesel. Looking like a Voltorb, actually. Nope. Go away. Post-leftism. Fuck off. Leftism, motherfuckers. Satirical politics. Actually, this is going to surprise a lot of people. Satirical politics. You know, because we all need a good laugh sometimes. We all need a good laugh. So, actually, I'll B-tier it. You know, it's in the middle there. It's kind of in the middle there. But, yeah, you know, sometimes we just need a good laugh, so. And that's it. That's all of them. So, yeah, that's, oh, God, Zuckerberg. Yeah, that's all of them. God, I hope he can't shut down that video just because I had that likeness of him in there. But, yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So, as you probably all guessed, my S tier, my A tier right there, my B tier, C for centrist or central, the D tier, and the dark zone or trash can of cringe. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's a lot of them down there. There's a lot of them that I would say really deserve to be down there. So yeah, that's pretty much all of it. That's everything. And you know, all things willing, I'll be able to upload this to YouTube and you'll be able to see this video. So until then, peace out, guys.
We all carry the cross and speak what we're taught. Lies and money become the white man's god. We burn all our bridges one too many times. The time has come now to draw the line. You know you got to stand.